us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Angel of Mighty Counsel. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he hath done marvelous things. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Given thine only begotten Son to take our nature upon him, And as at this time to be born of a pure virgin, grant that we, being regenerate and made thy children by adoption and grace, may daily be renewed by thy Holy Spirit, through the same our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee, and the same Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Here beginneth the second verse of the ninth chapter of the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation, and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, and as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden, and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Here endeth the lesson. The epistle is written in the first chapter of St. Paul's epistle to the Hebrews. God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory, and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. For unto which of the angels said he at any time, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee, and again I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. And again, when he bringeth in the first begotten into the world, he saith, And let all the angels of God worship him. And of the angels he saith, Who maketh his angels spirits, and his ministers a flame of fire? But unto the Son he saith, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, even thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. And thou, Lord, in the beginning hast laid the foundation of the earth, and heavens are the works of thine hands. They shall perish, but thou remainest, and they all shall wax old as doth a garment. And as a venture shalt them, though thou fold them up, and they shall be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years shall not fail. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the first chapter according to St. John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came to bear a witness to the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of the light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Praise be to thee, O Christ. Alleluia, alleluia, a hallowed day hath dawned upon us. Come all ye nations and worship the Lord, for on this day a great light hath descended upon the earth. Alleluia. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeded from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church, I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Nature seen, glory to the new.
the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Well, a Merry Christmas to you all. It's wonderful I can say that now. We want you all to have a joyous one. Hopefully you go back home to your families or friends and get a nap in if you haven't had one already. You know, sometimes Santa's helpers have been up all night and Santa Claus himself, I'm sure, is asleep at this time. But we are grateful for the real meaning of Christmas being celebrated here. And this is the heart of this holy day. And Christmas lasts how many days? The Christmas season.
12,
that's right. The 12 days of Christmas. That's why we call it holidays, holy days of Christmas. And then the Christmas ends on the Feast of the Epiphany when the Magi came, the wise men, to bring gifts to Jesus in Bethlehem. And then we begin the season of Epiphany. Isn't it just wonderful? It just keeps getting better and better, unfolding. More time to celebrate in our time and our walk with Jesus throughout the year. Well, you know, as I woke up this morning, I had 5 cups of coffee. And because I was here last night, we had a great crowd last night at 11 o'clock midnight mass. It was beautiful. We had the full choir. Jim, are you awake? I think you are because the music sounds great.
Well, thank you. I'm just barely awake.
Yeah, okay. And Abel's here again. He gets, 3 times in a row. That's 3 jewels in his crown. So that's great. But anyway, I wanted to let you know when I woke up this morning and I left and got in my car, I was kind of saddened because I see all these cars in parking lots and in the driveways, reminding us so many people are missing out on the real joy that Jesus, our Lord God, wants to give us. That there is purpose, there is meaning to life, that there is this great gift which God the Father has given us. And, you know, even since the dawn of human consciousness, as it says in the book, in the Bible, that every man that or woman that comes into the world, that God puts that divine illumination in every heart, a longing, a yearning for the Creator, to be with God, to be in His company, in His presence. And that's what we had in the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve. God walked with them in the garden. He was with them, present. He communed with them. He conversed with them. And it is His desire always to bring us back to Him. And so, since this longing and the human consciousness is to be with God, to be reconciled with Him, there is this, even in the myths of pagans of like Osiris and Baldur, of the Norman or Norse gods, this dying god, which is always seems to reappearing in mythology, pagan myths and whatnot. And so it is written in our hearts for this desire for God to be incarnate among us. Of course, we know He dies for us and then He has rebirth. He rises again. So in all these myths, we can't really pinpoint when these gods, you know, actually all this happened. But with Jesus, all those myths become a reality. In other words, they are fulfilled in Him because Jesus is more than a myth. He is a divine reality that He was born at a particular time, in a particular place. Remember, Bethlehem. It was prophesied by the prophets such as Micah some 600, 700 years ago that Jesus, the Messiah, would be born in Bethlehem. And so He was. And so even the census was fulfilled that prophecy when Caesar Augustus sent, okay, all everybody in the world is going to be taxed, so you have to go back to the place of your birth. For Joseph and Mary, they went back from Nazareth to Bethlehem and to fulfill that prophecy. Isn't that wonderful? But you see, mankind is searching more than just an awareness that God created all things. There's a deeper yearning within each of us, and that is what I want to focus on this morning. I think one wonderful way to illustrate that is with a true story of an English boy during the Second World War. And this English boy, because it was at the height of the war when the Nazi Germans were bombing London. They were trying to devastate the city, bring London down, bring England down, and Hitler and the Nazis would invade England eventually. And so a lot of the parents had to send their children away out into the countryside, away from the bombing that was occurring in London. And there was a little boy, and he had been separated from his home, his parents, and his family. And so he was sent to an American air base there in England. And an American soldier asked him, well, one Christmas, it was Christmas, he says, what do you want for Christmas? And the little boy looked up at him and said, all I want for Christmas is to be loved. All I want for Christmas is to be loved. You see, the great gift of Christmas in Christ is that the Creator loves us, that we are loved by our Creator. When we understand that and know that, that that is the gift that God the Father gives humanity, that Emmanuel, which means God among us, as prophesied by Isaiah 700 years before the birth of Christ, he would be born of a virgin mother. He would be conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, and God would once again dwell among us, but in a real, even more tangible way than he did when he walked with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. You see, we are in, if you will, Bethlehem right now. For Bethlehem means house of bread. And Jesus says, I am the bread of life, and I have come down from heaven that all who partake of me, this bread, will have life everlasting, new life, will be born again, will be have new beginnings, new hopes. Those sins which beset us, our own selfishness, our own things that proceed from the heart, those evils from the heart, which separate us from God and one another, that division, that discord, there will be peace, a unification not only within our own selves of all that wars against us, but there will be unity and peace among all mankind. That is the great gift the angels gave and announced to the world and to all mankind was unto you this day is born in the city of Bethlehem a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Isn't that wonderful? What that little boy was looking for on that day, we have found here in this house of bread, Bethlehem, when the very God of gods, Lord of lords, King of kings, is here in our very midst, in our very presence. His very presence is here among us because he desires, because he loves us so much, he desires to be in our midst, to commune with us, to be ever with us, not only today, but forever. And so we can lose that companionship of him if we get distracted by lesser things, lesser loves, rather than the only love that will completely fulfill us, and that is God, Jesus. We can take him with us outside these doors. He can commune with us ever in his holy word, in the sacraments of the church, in the Holy Eucharist, when he is made known to us in the breaking of bread, as it says in the Gospels. The risen Christ abides in you and we in him. Our sins can be broken. We can overcome them through his grace and his might and his power. Now, we'll never be perfect like he is, but he is our model of the perfect sinless man, the one who walked the earth and showed us what we are capable of and what we will be in him one day, maybe not in this life, but certainly in the next. We will learn what it means to be loved by God, and in turn, we can't help but love him and one another in return. Isn't that wonderful to know that the heart of the faith is really a romance? It's a courtship with God. You and I have been given that gift here. It is as Dante said in Paradiso, he said, that love that unfolds into other loves. In the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. While we have time, let us do good unto all men, and especially unto them that are the household. give glory and praise to God for the beauty of this day in commemoration of the birthday of our Lord Jesus. But did you know that the word Christmas really is from Christ Mass? And so Christ Mass is what we're doing here. Because when Jesus, the Son of God, the second person of the Holy Trinity, who has always existed from all of eternity, when he came into the womb of the Virgin Mary and took on our flesh, he assumed our very humanity into heaven itself. So therefore, our worship here on earth joins with that of heaven. Isn't that a wonderful mystery to contemplate and to know that God is here and we join with a heavenly host of heaven to worship him? In addition to your own personal prayer intentions this morning, please pray for all those mentioned in the parish bulletin prayer list. There are many who are suffering, many who do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, who see no purpose or meaning to life. We pray for them that they may come to know Christ. We also pray for the hungry, the lonely, those who are out on the streets, especially those in Vegas, our youth and adults and children living on the streets. We pray for those who are being persecuted for their faith all around the world. We pray for those who are in prisons or being subjected to emotional, physical, or spiritual abuse, that they will be freed from their oppressors. We pray for all those who are engaged in all manner of evil and sin. We pray that they will repent and come to Christ. Pray for this nation. Pray for our leaders. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice for the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life and thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
You do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God devoutly you. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and it institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
O our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory,
past, present, and to come, and at the intercession of the blessed, glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with that of thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, of Andrew, and of all thy saints, Favorably grant peace in our time, that by the help of thy mercy we may ever be kept free from sin and safe from all disquietude. Through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but of thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come into my room, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come into my room, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come into my room, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost be upon you and remain with you always. Thank you. We thank thee for the daughters vouchsafed to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And just assure us thereby thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people. And are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you.
Amen.